Best Kodi Addons for January 2018 by Security Gladiators. Welcome back to another guide, everyone. Today we're going to show you the best Kodi Addons for January 2018, as I said. Just be aware, it's the 27th of the 12th, they're all working when tested today, but as we all know with Kodi, they might shift around and stop working at any time. Please keep watching and check out what the latest and greatest add-ons for Kodi are. Thanks. To make sure you stay up to date with the latest news about Kodi and so you don't miss any of our videos, make sure you subscribe to our channel and leave a comment if you have any questions. Guys, as I always mention, our guides are for educational purposes only. And if you choose to download or stream any third-party content on Kodi or anything else, that's entirely up to you. However, if you're going to do it, as always, we recommend using a VPN, and the VPN that we choose to use with Kodi is IPVANISH. I'll put the link in the description. However, you can head over to securitygladiators.com and check out the IPVANISH review that we've done here. You click on the link halfway through the page, you can also get a pretty decent discount. You can just click on pricing up here and you can see there it's $650 a month for a full year there. Without further ado, now I'll bring you the five best Kodi add-ons. One that we're all familiar with is Exodus, and that's why we're going to recommend it in Best Kodi Add-ons for January 2018. If you're looking for a Kodi add-on to stream unlimited and free movies and TV shows, you'll find it in Exodus. The Exodus Kodi add-on grants you access to a varied library of online streaming sources. Just be aware, guys, although you probably already are, that Exodus repositories are getting harder and harder to find. We've got one here that still works, which I'm going to put in the description, but be aware, like any add-on, I guess, any third-party add-on, but especially Exodus, as I've been cracking down it, may change very quickly and without notice. I'm not going to go through the installation guides today. I'm just going to go through a review of the actual add-ons, and Exodus is the first one that I'm recommending for the reasons I said before. I'll click into it and you'll be able to see some of the content there, but I'm sure you're probably all aware of it. With Exodus, it's one of my favorite features is the search function. So if you're in movies or TV shows, you can just click search. It'll also save your old searches, so we can go Star Wars. I think The Last Jedi was the last one. Last Jedi, and we'll see what comes up, and it will actually go through and search it for you. This is available from the kdil.co/repo repository, but I'll actually put that in. You can see there, it has come up, The Last Jedi 2017. I am getting, I've been using it lately and I've been getting mixed results with its operation. I've been asking a few of the guys that have downloaded it from our YouTube channel, and it's the same thing. So I'll give you a couple of other ones that do TV shows and movies as well. That way you'll always have a backup. Covenant is the next best Kodi add-on for January 2018. In my opinion, it's essentially an Exodus replacement. It's actually not that much different than Exodus at all. And it's great because it offers everything you would expect. You may want to add this to your list, I think. And the best thing about it is it's actually available from the same repo. I think there's three add-ons today which will be all from the same repo. There'll be Exodus, Covenant and Poseidon. Going into Covenant, you'll find the layout is pretty much the same as Exodus. You've got titles for movies, TV shows, my movies if you've saved any to these, new movies, new episodes, and channels. We can have a look in TV shows, and we can search by genres, networks, languages, what people are watching and the most popular or the most highly rated. We can go into new TV shows, click on that. Let's have a look at Little Women. No idea what this show is, never heard of it. And you can see, yeah, look, the layout is pretty much exactly the same as Exodus, so there's not much to really show there. I like it because when Exodus isn't working, I can come over to Covenant and generally get something to work, or vice versa. Or sometimes I will just come to Covenant as well, just as we know, as I spoke about, Exodus is getting harder and harder to find a working repository. And the third add-on we're adding to our list of best Kodi add-ons for January 2018 is Poseidon. Again, very much like the previous two, a lot like Exodus and Covenant. I really only use Poseidon just as a third alternative, I guess, as a backup to my backup. Their movie selections aren't as good, their TV show selection isn't as good, but it is a good backup if the other two are down, or you might find Poseidon down as well and you use the other ones. The features are much the same. It has a search function. You can search by actors, you can search TV shows. It has new TV shows, new movies, it has older movies as well. One of the features that I don't particularly like about it is that you do have to select your source once you've actually gone through and pick the episode that you want. So it won't, I don't think you have the option to autoplay like you do in Exodus and Covenant. So it can be a bit slower sometimes, but as a third option and a backup option to Exodus, if that's your favorite, or Covenant, we do recommend Poseidon. I'll show you what I mean by having to choose your providers as soon as this loads. So you can see there on the right hand side, you actually have to go through. Some people do prefer that, and that's fine, but I'd rather do it all automatically for me. However, yep, it is in our list for best Kodi add-ons January 2018. Fourth best Kodi add-on for January 2018 is UK Turks playlist. This is one of the oldest add-ons, I guess, one of the legends of Kodi, and it's probably right up there again with Exodus. Probably better than, in some people's opinion, than what Exodus was, and they actually still managed to bring a heap of content. They also do regular updates that'll fix non-working links. There's a ton of great UK and Turkish live TV streams. It's got really good live sports, documentaries, stand-up comedy, classic cartoons, concerts, and heaps more. This is actually one of my favourite ones, to be honest. And there's a ton of stuff, not just from the UK or Turkey. There's a bunch of live sports stuff from the US, Canada, Australia, There's even stuff for NFL fans in there on for 720p streaming. It's quite easy to use. It's quite a good layout as well. As you can see there on my page, pretty much everything I've just gone through. This comes highly recommended, guys, and I find this one actually works more often than Exodus and the others. Probably with this one though, you will tend to need a VPN for some of the channels, so you can make it look as if you're coming in through the UK. Okay, everyone, the fifth and final best Kodi add-on for January 2017 is an adult channel. I'm not going to talk too much about it because YouTube may actually ban the video and we don't want that. But it's called Ultimate White Cream. It's available at the same repository address that I've put on all the other videos. And what I'll actually do is run through an install just to show you. I wasn't going to at the start, but because they're all from the same repository, it should be pretty easy. But Ultimate White Cream, if I just glance over it, has a bunch of movies. It's got hentai, it's got tubes, it's got webcams and live streams as well, and a whole bunch of favorites. As far as adult channels go, it's as good as the rest. But like I said, I won't talk too much about it. But I will go in and show you how I've installed all of today's add-ons, which is super easy because they all come from the same repository. So if you don't know, you need to go back to the start, all the way back. You need to click on the little gear cog up the top. Go ahead and click on that, and then you've got File Manager down in the right hand side, and you need to click on that one. And then you're going to need to, if you don't have already any of these from the KDL repository, you're going to need to click Add Source. And where it says None, you need to click on that. And then you need to type in HTTP --/ and it's KDIL. Oops, don't know why that's not typing. Give me a sec. KDIL.co/ repo, and then just hit OK, and then you just rename that. You can put a little star so it comes up the top of your list and name it KDIL. Click OK and hit OK again, and if it's found the source correctly, it should just take a couple of seconds, and no error message, so that's a good sign. So now we go back again, and then we go down to add-ons, we click on that, we go up to the little unpackaging box on the top left hand corner, and we go ahead and click on that, and then we go install from zip file, go ahead and click on that, and then as you can see, I've already got a bunch of different zip files in there, but you can see that's the one we just put in, which was star KDIL. So I'll double click on that. You'll find it'll just say updated. So we go KDIL, and it'll probably say updated instead of installed. Yours won't say installed. We'll just give it a few seconds. Somewhere up in the top right hand corner, it should come up with a message or notification. Just give that a sec because it actually says it's not responding now. And that's come back to life. And then we can go install from repository. And then we just find the KDIL repository. You see it just there. We click on that. And then we go down to video add-ons. Double click on that. And in this list you'll find everything I've given you today. You see it's updated there. On the top right hand, so you've got Exodus, you'll have Covenant, Poseidon, UK Turks, and Ultimate White Cream. There's a whole bunch of other ones there which you should feel free to look through as well. You might find something better than we've reviewed today. If you do, let us know in the comments. But essentially, once you've found the add-on that you want, you double click on it, and let me see if I can find one. I'll go supports devil. All you need to do, sorry, that's not a good one because I've already got that installed. Say supports hub, which I have no idea what that is because I haven't used it. You just click install, and that'll install it back to your video add-ons page. And that's essentially it. Thanks again for watching Security Gladiators, guys. Please be sure to subscribe, like, and comment on our videos, especially if something's not working or something you don't like. Let us know why. So hopefully we can fix it. But if you do like it or you have a video that you want us to make, just let us know. Cheers. Thanks.